The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went to the Mount of Olives, but early in the morning he arrived again in the temple area. And when the people started coming to him, and he sat down and taught them. Then the scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery, and made her stand in the middle. They said to him, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. Now, in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such women. So what do you say?" They said this to test him, so that they could have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and began to write on the ground with his finger. But when they continued asking him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let the one among you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her." Again, he bent down and wrote on the ground. Then, and in response, they went away one by one, beginning with the elders. So he was left alone with the woman before him. Then Jesus straightened up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She replied, "No one, sir." Then Jesus said, "Neither do I condemn you. Go, and from now on, do not sin anymore." The Gospel of the Lord. It is Sunday of Lent. Next Sunday it will be Palm Sunday, and then we'll begin the Holy Week. To commit adultery, I have no experience, but I think you need to have a man and a woman. Why then, in the Gospel of this morning, there is only the woman? Where is the man? If the woman is guilty, also the man should be guilty. The point is that we can see the conditions of the women at Jesus' time, and it is the conditions of many girls in Arab country. If you were born in Afghanistan, Iraq, Brunei, Indonesia, where the Sharia is the law, we made useless. A horse, a camel, it must be more important than a woman. In this country, it is like that. And you are lucky to be born in the Philippines. And you are lucky to be living on Hong Kong. Just last week, a woman in Afghanistan was caught listening to modern music. And they asked her to kneel down and to be beat 13 times with a whip. During the past week, were you listening to modern music? Yes, I suppose so. So if you were living in those countries, this was the situation in the Old Testament, Jesus' time. And so this man who caught the woman asked Jesus, "What can we do with her? Moses told us to stone her to death." What are you going to say? This dirty man, they were just concerned with Jesus. They couldn't care less about the women. So they want to tell Jesus. They want to know Jesus' opinion. And Jesus didn't answer them. He bent down. He started writing what? We don't know. But we know that when they asked again, "Jesus, what can we do with her?" Jesus stood up and said, "Who among you, man, and without sin. Try and stone her. And one by one, starting from the older one, he went away. You can see the difference between the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament, Moses was telling people, you must kill these women. Jesus is compassion. Jesus is asking the woman, where are they? Did anyone condemn you? Neither I do condemn you, but from now on, do not sin anymore. Just to commit adultery is a sin, but it is a sin of wickednesses. We need love. We need the protection. We need someone to stay with us, but we don't want to offend God. This is the point. If you have the opportunity of reading the last letter of Pope Francis, Christus Vivit, is telling us clearly the mind of the church today about sex. If you have an opportunity, go in the internet. You can go in the internet. Have a read in Tagalog. I don't know if they read in Tagalog now. Certainly there is in English. Read it. What Pope Francis is telling us. We are, sexuality is not a sin. Because God made us like that. But to just throw stone against those who commit a sin, who make a mistake, that is the true sin. So, sisters, I invite you during this week to be compassionate like Jesus was. Forgive and you will be forgiven. Be humble and Jesus will elevate you. Be stay with Jesus and pray during this week. It is the last week of Lent. Next Sunday, it will be already Gloria Sunday. The enter in Jerusalem by Jesus.